Hi there! My name is Dimitris Haralambidis, I am a mathematics teacher, and in this video we are going to talk about the different forms of a line's equation. We'll begin by mentioning that a straight line can be algebraically expressed in four different forms. At first, we have the slope-intercept form, which is a form written as y equals mx plus c. Secondly, we have the point-slope form, which is the form y minus y1 equals m times x minus x1. Thirdly, we have the standard form, which is the form ax plus by equals c. And lastly, we have the general form of a straight line, which is the form ax plus by plus c equals 0. We will now go in depth and see each one of these four cases. We'll begin with the first case where we have the slope-intercept form, or in other words, the gradient-intercept form of a line. By definition, we can denote that any expression written in the form y equals mx plus c graphically represents a straight line and is called slope-intercept form. Through this form, one can determine the slope of the line, which is the value of m, and shows the direction of the line, and can also determine the y-intercept of the line, which is the y-coordinate of the point at which the graph of that line cuts the y-axis. The y-intercept of that line will be equal to the value of c. Let's work some examples on that. State the slope and the y-intercept of the given line L in each case. First, we have the form y equals 3x plus 5, so it's obvious here that the slope of that line will be equal to 3, while the y-intercept of that line will be equal to 5 respectively. Secondly, we have the form y equals negative 2x plus 3 over 5. Similarly here, slope will be equal to negative 2, while the y-intercept will be equal to 3 fifths. Next, we have the form y equals x plus 1. Here, it's supposed to be the slope of the line is supposed to be number 1, because x can be written as 1 times x. Therefore, the line's slope will be number 1, while the y-intercept of the line will be equal to 1 also. On the fourth case, we have a special case, y equals 5. The reason that this line is special is because its slope is 0. Indeed, you can simply understand that y equals 5 was originally created from the expression y equals 0x plus 5. Therefore, the slope of such a line is equal to 0, while the y-intercept in this specific case will be equal to 5. And lastly, we have y equals 2x. Here, we obviously have a slope of 2, while the y-intercept is not there. This means that the y-intercept should be 0. We can determine the slope-intercept form of a line in two different ways, either by having two points of the line, or by having one point of the line and the line's slope. Let's see an example. Find the slope-intercept form of the line that passes through points A with coordinates 2 and 10, and B with coordinates 4 and 18 respectively. Let's work the solution. Since we are looking for the slope-intercept form of that line, we are certainly that we are looking for a form y equals mx plus c. So all I need now is to estimate these specific values of m and c. M, as I mentioned earlier, will be the line's slope, and I already know, or at least I should already know, that the slope of a line can be given as the slope created by two points on that line. Since I have my two points A and B, I can use the slope formula, which states that m is equal y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1, and then apply the coordinates of the given points on that formula directly. By doing that, I get that m is equal to 18 minus 10 over 4 minus 2, thus m is equal to 4. So I so far know that the slope-intercept form of the line I'm searching for will be a line written in the form y equals 4x plus c. I still need to find the value of c. To find c, I can use any of the given points, either a and b, and just think the following. A point lies on a line if its coordinates satisfy the line's equation. Let's say that again. A point, a random point, lies on a given line if its coordinates satisfy the line's equation. This means that for any of the given points I choose to use, either A or B, if I substitute its coordinates in place of x and y respectively, then this substitution will produce a true statement. And by true statement, I mean something that always holds true. 5 equals 5, 10 equals 10, and so on. In this case, I chose point A. So, I will go to the form I already have, y equals 4x plus c, and plug in 2 in place of x and 10 in place of y respectively. And I am positive that whatever comes out, it will be true. So, we would get that 10 equals 4 times 2 plus c, which means that 10 equals 8 plus c, which obviously means that c is equal to 2. And finally, that's exactly the slope-intercept form of the line I was looking for. It will be the form y equals 4x plus 2. Let's work now a second example, where in this case we are provided with just one point and the line's slope. Find the slope-intercept form of the line that passes through the point A with coordinates 3 and 7 and has a slope of 2. Like I did before, I will once again begin by writing the slope-intercept form of a line. It's the form y equals mx plus c. And like I did before, still here, all I need to do is calculate the values of m and c. In this case, though, slope was given directly and was given to have a value of 2. This means that m is equal to 2. I can substitute that and I can now say that the slope-intercept form of the line that I'm searching for will be the form y equals 2x plus c. To find c, I will use the given point. And once again, I will take the coordinates of the point, I will substitute them in place of x and y. So I'm going to substitute in this case x equals 3 and y equals 7. And I'm totally positive, I'm totally sure that whatever comes out will be a true statement. By doing that, I get that 7 equals 2 times 3 plus c, which means that 7 equals 6 plus c, which finally means that c is equal to 1. Hence, the slope-intercept form I was searching for will be the form y equals 2x plus 1. Let's move now in the second case. It's the point-slope form of a line. By definition, any expression written in the form y minus y1 equals m times x minus x1 will be called point-slope form of a line. Through such a form, one can easily understand the line's slope, which is going to be m, and a point that lies on that line. This point will be the point with coordinates x1, y1. Like with the first case, here as well, to find the point-slope form of a line, we either need 2 points of the line or simply 1 point of the line and the line's slope. Example. Find the point-slope form of the line that passes through the points A with coordinates 4 and 10 and B with coordinates 3 and 15 respectively. I will begin by calculating the line's slope through the slope formula. M is equal to y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1, which means that m is equal to 15 minus 10 over 3 minus 4, which means that m equals 5 over negative 1, which finally means that m is equal to negative 5. Now that I have the line's slope, I need to use one of the given points. If I use the coordinates of A, numbers 4 and 10, then the point slope form of that line will be the form y minus 10 equals the slope, negative 5, multiplied by x minus 4. On the other hand, if I use the coordinates of point B, the point slope form of the same line will be the form y minus 15 equals negative 5 multiplied by x minus 3. Notice here that although they don't seem equal, both of them express the same line. In fact, if we decide to make operations, both of them will lead to the same expression. In the previous example, we were given two points of the line and we were asked to find its point slope form. Now in this one, we are given one point of it alongside with its slope, and we are still asked to find the point slope form of that line. The conditions that we are given makes the whole process a lot easier, because basically we have everything we need. We have the value of m, which is the slope, so m is equal to negative 6. We also have the coordinates of the given point. x1 will be equal to negative 2, while y1 will be equal to 5. All I need to do now is calculate these values of m, x1 and x2 directly in the formula I mentioned before. Therefore, the point slope form of the line that passes through point A with a slope of negative 6 will be the form y minus y1, thus y minus 5, equals m, in other words, negative 6, multiplied by x minus x1, x minus negative 2, which would become x plus 2. At this point, it would be interesting to see the changes between slope form of a line and its point slope form. Example, write the slope-intercept form of the line described by y minus 4 equals 3 multiplied by x minus 6. So, basically, in this example, we need to go from the point slope form of a line into its slope-intercept form. All we need to do is simply apply some distributive property. Starting from y minus 4 equals 3 multiplied by x minus 6, I will apply the distributive property, and this will become y minus 4 equals 3x minus 18. Next, I will leave y on the left side, and everything else will be moved on the right side. And this will create the expression y equals 3x minus 18 plus 4, or in other words, the expression y equals 3x minus 14. And that's exactly the slope-intercept form I needed. On a reverse way now, for starting from the slope-intercept form y equals 2x plus 8, in order to find the corresponding or one of the corresponding point slope forms, I could take the constant term, in this case 8, and break it in a sum in a way that one term of that sum is equal to the coefficient of x, to 2, plus something else. It's obvious that 8 can be written as 2 plus 6, and the reason I did that is because now I want 2x and 2 to be taken together and apply over there a common factor. So I'm going to write y equals 2 multiplied by x plus 1 plus 6, and now I'm going to pass positive 6 from the right side to the left side, and this will create the form y minus 6 equals to 2 multiplied by x plus 1. And from this form, which is a point slope form of that line, I can easily see that the slope will still be 2, and I know that one point of that line will be the point with coordinates negative 1 and 6. Let's see the two last cases, standard form of a line and general form of a line. The reason we learn them together is because basically they are the same thing. Let's start with the standard form. By definition, any expression in the form ax plus by equals c is called standard form of a line. To find the standard form of a line, one must firstly find either the slope-intercept or the point-slope form of the line, and then rearrange the terms so that those that involve variables get on one side. Similarly, any expression in the form ax plus by plus c equals 0 is called general form of a line. It is obvious that, similarly to the standard form, to get the general form of a line, we would have first to find the line's slope-intercept form or slope-point form, and then the only difference here would be that we would need to rearrange all the terms in a way so that we leave 0 on one side. Let's see an example. Find the general form of the line passing through points A with coordinates 2 and negative 5 and B with coordinates negative 4 and 3. We'll begin by calculating the slope through the formula y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. By doing careful operations, we would get that the slope in this case is equal to negative 4 over 3. Now, I'm going to use the point slope form. Y minus y1 equals m multiplied by x minus x1. Knowing that the slope's value is equal to negative 4 over 3, and by using the coordinates of A, I would get that the point slope form would be equal to y minus negative 5, so y plus 5, equals to negative 4 over 3 multiplied by x minus 2. I'm applying the distributive property, and that can be written as y plus 5 equals negative 4 over 3 times x plus 8 over 3. Now, sometimes we might be asked to write the general form ax plus by plus c equals 0 in a way that a, b, and c are integers. In this case, all we need to do is multiply all terms of that expression by the LCM of the denominators. The denominators here are both equal to 3. This means that I need to multiply all terms by 3. By doing that, I would get an equivalent expression, 3y plus 15 equals negative 4x plus 8. To find the general form now, I should bring everything on one side. I chose to bring everything on the left side, and I would get that 4x plus 3y plus 15 minus 8 equals 0, which means that 4x plus 3y plus 7 is 0. And that is the general form I was looking for. And that would be all. For any questions you might have regarding the content we just viewed, or any possible collaboration, you can always contact me. As always, thank you for your time.